In this video, I am going to discuss practices for expressing tolerances on linear and angular dimensions, and interpretations governing limits and tolerances. The applicability of material condition modifiers on geometric tolerance values will be covered in the following videos, so don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Limits and directly applied tolerance values are specified by limit dimensioning and plus and minus tolerancing. So let's begin with limit dimensioning. The high limit, that is the maximum value, is placed above the low limit, which is the minimum value. Well, when expressed in a single line, the low limit precedes the high limit, and the dash separates the two values, as illustrated on the screen. Plus and minus tolerancing, the dimension is given first and is followed by a plus and minus expression of tolerance. Let's first take a look at bilateral tolerancing. As you can see, plus and minus sign is followed by a tolerance value of 0.25. When the upper limit is different from lower limit, then the tolerance values are expressed separately as shown on the screen. When we look at the unilateral dimension, only the applicable tolerance is mentioned along with its respective sign, and the other tolerance value is kept as zero as shown on the drawing. Here we are going to look at the two examples, with positive and negative tolerance, as seen on the screen. Where millimeter dimensions are used on the drawings, the unilateral tolerancing is used, and either the plus or minus value is nil, a single zero is shown without a plus or minus sign. In this example, the 20 value is the nominal size. For bilateral tolerancing is used, both the plus and minus values have the same number of decimal places, using zeros where necessary. In this example, the 20 value is the nominal size. But if the decimal places are not the same, then it will be not a good practice. We have to keep the same decimal places, although the zero does not have significance after the decimal point. We have to keep the zero. Well, inch tolerances slightly differ from millimeter tolerances. Where inch dimensions are used on the drawing, the unilateral tolerancing is used, and either that plus or minus value is nil, its dimension shall be expressed with the same number of decimal places, and the appropriate plus or minus sign, as seen on the screen. But if we keep only zero without decimal places as we did for millimeter tolerances, it is not a good practice. For bilateral tolerancing is used, both the plus and minus values and the dimension have the same number of decimal places, as seen on the screen. But if the decimal places of the nominal value differ from the tolerances, then it is not a good practice. Note, where basic dimensions are used, associated tolerances contain the number of decimal places necessary for control. There is no requirement for the basic dimension value to be expressed with the same number of decimal places as the tolerance. Interpretation of limits. All limits are absolute. Dimensional limits, regardless of the number of decimal places, are used as if they were continued with zeros. In this case, 20.01 means 20.010000 and so on. For plated or coated parts, where a part is to be plated or coated, the drawing or reference document shall specify whether the dimensions apply before or after plating. A typical example of note is displayed on the screen, which read as dimensional limits apply after plating. Single limits. Mean or max is placed after a dimension where other elements of the design definitely determine the other unspecified limit. Features, such as depths of holes, lengths of threads, corner radii, chamfers, etc., may be limited in this way. Single limits are used where the intent will be clear, and the unspecified limit can be zero or approach infinity, and will not result in a condition detrimental to the design. Tolerance accumulation. We are going to discuss three methods of tolerance accumulation, which are chain dimensioning, baseline dimensioning, and direct dimensioning. Let's consider chain dimensioning first. The maximum variation between the two features is equal to the sum of the tolerances on the intermediate distances. This results in the greatest tolerance accumulation. As seen in this illustration, the tolerance accumulation between surfaces X and Y is plus 0.15. For baseline dimensioning, the maximum variation between two features is equal to the sum of the tolerances on the two dimensions from their origin to the features. This results in a reduction of the tolerance accumulation. As seen in the illustration, the tolerance accumulation between surfaces X and Y is plus minus sine 0.1 for direct dimensioning. The maximum variation between the two features is controlled by the tolerance on the dimension between the features, which is X and Y. This results in the least tolerance. As illustrated on the screen, the tolerance between features X and Y is plus minus 0.05. Now, let's take a look at dimensional limits related to an origin. In certain cases, it is necessary to indicate that a dimension between two features shall originate from one of these features and not the other. In this case, this shorter surface feature is selected. The high points of the surface indicated as the origin define a plane for measurement. The dimensions related to the origin are taken from the plane or axis, and define a zone within which the other features, which is longer surface, in this case, must lie. Remember that, this concept does not establish a datum reference frame. Such a case where a part having two parallel surfaces of unequal length is to be mounted on the shorter surface. In this example, the dimension origin symbol signifies that the dimension originates from the plane established by the shorter surface. Without such an indication, the longer surface could have been selected as the origin, thus permitting a greater angular variation between surfaces, as shown on the screen, which is not correct practice. With this, we come to an end of this video. More tolerancing methods are discussed in the following videos. If you find this video informative, then subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, and access my more videos on geometric dimensioning and tolerancing.